week, of course, the moccasins of UT Chattanooga coming in, and they're always tough.
Well, they played East Kentucky great, but East Tennessee beat them, and looks like we're going to have some tough games in the league. We've got Chattanooga coming up, East Tennessee, Appalachians, of course, tough. Marshall played Eastern Kentucky real good, so it looks like it's anybody's guess as who can win this conference.
Definitely looks like one of those seasons where it's going to be you beat them, they're going to beat you, and then someone else is going to beat someone else.
Probably going to be that way. I still like our chances. I think our club showed some good things last night. We came back when we were down. Nobody ever actually gave up, and we just got to pull together and make things happen.
Now, you've been around a while, Coach. Is a loss ever good?
Not to me, it's not, but hopefully we'll make something out of it and make the best of it.
Chattanooga, what do they do well, in your opinion?
Well, Chattanooga's always played great defense. They've led the league in total defense almost every year but last year. They have hard-nosed players, they have physical players, and we'll have to do a good job offensively against their defense.
Are they still as good a defense as they used to be when Coach Pate was there? I know he's now with Coach Sheridan at NC State.
I think so. They still have some good players on defense. They didn't have quite as good a season last year, but they held Eastern Kentucky to less than 100 yards offense, so they have some good players.
All right, Corporate Day coming up next Saturday at Paladin Stadium. Hope to see a lot of you Paladin fans out there when the Paladins come home to go up against the very tough Mocs of UTC. Coach Satterfield, good luck next Saturday, and thanks a lot for watching live on this Saturday, or Sunday morning, excuse me, with Coach Jimmy Satterfield, and we'll see you again next Sunday.
The tradition continues. Is Hardee's, Quincy's, and TV7's Premier Night. Get $3 off the regular ticket price for Premier Night by picking up a discount coupon at all area Hardee's and Quincy's family steakhouses. Tickets are on sale now. For additional information, call 803-582-8107.
Hi, I'm Bob Chewback.
I'm Jimmy Satterfield, coach of the Furman Paladins.
Join the coach and me for Furman Football 87 live Sunday mornings at 8. We'll have highlights of the game, special features giving you insight on Furman both on and off the field, and we'll show you how the Paladins are planning for the upcoming game. So join us Sunday mornings at 8 on TV7 for Furman Football 87, the Jimmy Satterfield Show.
With 18 translators serving you.
It's crunch time for the Furman Paladins, 4th and 7 from the Moccasin 25. Moore will drop back to pass. He's looking down the right side. He's got a man at the wall. It's Larry Grady. 1st and goal, Furman.
The tradition continues. Furman Football 87, the Jimmy Satterfield Show. Brought to you by your Upstate Nissan dealer. And by Pepsi, the taste born in the Carolinas.
Looking for the best truck deal in town? Your Nissan dealer's got it. With sensational year-end savings up to $900 on the biggest selection of hard-body trucks and rugged four-wheel drive Pathfinders. We've got to make room for the 88 models, so we're dealing on every truck and Pathfinder in stock. And now special factory incentives could save you up to $900 more. That means this could be your best chance ever to get the deal of a lifetime on a new Nissan truck. Get big year-end savings at your Upstate South Carolina Nissan dealer.
Now, here's Coach Satterfield with your host, Bob Chewback.
Well, a good Sunday morning to you, and for the second consecutive week, unfortunately, we're not able to bring you too much good news, because for the second straight week, the Furman Paladins came up on the losing end of a Southern Conference ball game yesterday. Yesterday, the opposition was UT Chattanooga, and Coach, coming off the loss against Western Carolina, I know your ball club was hungry, but it looked like Chattanooga was hungry, too.
Well, they played good enough to win yesterday. Our players played hard. We did some good things. We just didn't do enough of them.
When going into the ball game, looked like they were more of a running team, but as the stats show out, and as we look at the highlights, they threw the ball an awful lot.
Well, it's pretty difficult to run against our defense. We played good defense, and they had to pass the ball to move it, and so they felt like that was the most effective way and begin to pass it more.
Obviously, though, you felt good going into the game, didn't you?
We felt like we had a great chance to win the game like we have the last 2 weeks. And of course, we did have a chance to win. We just didn't do enough things right at the end to win the football game. We're in the game at the end. Our players showed a lot of courage, a lot of character in coming back when we were out of it and got back ahead. But I thought we'd win it at the end, but we didn't quite do it.
All right. Furman against UT Chattanooga yesterday at Paladin Stadium, Corporate Day in Greenville. And we'll take a look at those first half highlights right after we take a look at the players of the week from the Western Carolina ball game.
Deal on a new luxury car? Your Nissan dealer's got it. With sensational year-end savings on all Stanzas and Maximas, we've got the best selection ever of quality-built Nissan cars, and we've got to move them fast. Come in now, and we'll sweeten the deal with factory incentives that could save you up to $700 on Stanzas or up to $900 on Maximas. Big selection, year-end savings, and factory incentives. Get the deal of a lifetime. Get big year-end savings at your upstate South Carolina Nissan dealer.
Fans, it all comes down to this moment. This is where it all gets decided. Johnson steps in, checks the signs, makes a few adjustments. This is a classic confrontation. He's digging in. Here's the delivery. And there it goes. He's going back, back, way back. It is going, going. It is gone.
Pepsi, the choice of a new generation.
Furman's second consecutive week of Southern Conference play yesterday. UT Chattanooga providing the opposition at Paladin Stadium in Greenville. We have first half highlights, and here come the Paladins out on the field. And for the first time this year, Coach, we had good weather to start the ballgame, and the bright, sunshiny skies held up all throughout the afternoon.
Maybe it should rain. We play better in the rain, I think. Maybe we need a rainy day. It was a great day. It was a great day for a football game, and everything was right except the score.
Looked like the crowd was pretty good.
Had a good crowd. The fans were into the game, students, and we did a good job. But a lot of areas just didn't quite come up with enough of them. Great play by Jeff Blankenship.
Chattanooga has the football first. Furman wins the toss, elects to defer until the second half. Julius Dixon, great pursuit here.
Good pursuit. Good tackle by Julius. He's played good all year for us. Another good play. Great effort right here by Blankenship, number 50, to get another sack. Al Peterson.
That was on a third down play, too, so they punt the football. However, poor field position for Furman. You had to punt it right back, and Chattanooga's in business once more.
We didn't do a very good job on offense, particularly the first half. They had the ball a lot more than we did, and the defense really had to play too much.
Russell Rush made a good play, then Sammy Cooper coming up with a stop here. Now they're inside your 10-yard line, and they're going to throw an incompletion here.
Good contain here by Adrian. A great play by Julius Dixon, almost interception.
Now it's third down, and Stan Nix is the quarterback for Chattanooga. He is the coach's son, and he's going to try to throw it again, but Brian Pitts runs him out of bounds.
A super effort there by Darrell Gardner, diving over one of their blockers, and Brian Pitts runs him out of bounds.
Very short field goal attempt here. They miss it, so you dodge a bullet off the bat, and it's still nothing-nothing.
They missed several field goals, but they made the one that counted at the end, and this is a good run by Kenneth Goldsmith. We just couldn't get anything going on offense. We didn't do a good job on first down plays, and they got the ball again.
All right, Chattanooga with it, and Adrian Dupre with a pretty good play.
Good tackle, and defense is just having to stay on the field too much.
Gang tackling here. Blankenship hit him. I believe Garrett Perry hit him.
Russell Rush got a lot of good gang tackling on defense. We played good on defense.
Mox again, though, deep in Furman territory, and Darrell Gardner with a nice play.
Darrell played great, probably had one of his best games. We had great effort from the defense. I think our players played hard. We just made some mistakes that cost us.
Chattanooga fumbled seven times and didn't lose any of them.
Didn't lose a fumble. They fumbled seven times, fumbled a snap about seven times, and you usually don't win ball games when you do that kind of thing.
First play of the second quarter, you had the quarterback running. However, then he breaks free, and someone broke free in the end zone.
Well, we had him surrounded, and they just made a play. We had the same kind of thing happen against us against Western last week, and those kind of things seem to hurt you most when you aren't playing good.
7-0 in favor of the Mocs. This is the third down play, and Chris is going up top to John Bagg. Well, you need the 10. He only gets 8.
Their defensive backs make some good hits. That's one of them right there.
Chattanooga, though, can't get a first down either. Blankenship stopping Caldwell there on third down.
Good individual tackle by Jeff to stop him.
This is a super drive coming up now, and Kenneth Goldsmith picks up not only the first play of the drive, but the first down of the ball game.
It was first down we made. We finally got something going with some options and moved the ball some.
Good hit here, but Chris still got 8 yards.
Good stick. Their defensive backs made some good tackles.
Third down and 2, and Chris gets 2 yards plus 21 more. 23 big ones here.
It's a good run. He looked like he may have had a chance to break it. He had one player there, and he stumbles down and falls.
Looks like good blocking there.
Had excellent blocking. Bill Duncan, Kenneth Goldsmith, Alex Albert, Mark Brown. Had good execution on that play.
Now it's first and 10, next play at the 34, and you break another long one.
This is an option. Bill Duncan makes a key block. John gets a good run, gets about 5 extra yards after he gets hit. That's the kind of thing we like to see.
That puts it all the way down at the Chattanooga 6, and we're going to take a look at it from up on top, and you can see the block by number 89 there.
Bill Duncan makes a key block. Fee Cowan, Elton Bailey, and John makes a nice run.
The very next play, you're going to give it to Lamar Bell.
Probably didn't give it to Lamar enough. He gave it to him twice inside the 10. He scored twice.
You say this is similar to a play from last year?
Just like the play we ran against him last year to Lamar. We probably need to put more plays in for Lamar. He's a good runner. Shows it here and has 2 touchdown runs on that same play.
He saw the corner of the end zone and went for it. So it's all tied up right now at 7 apiece. Furman against Chattanooga. You see the time there on the clock still in the second quarter. Chattanooga gets the football back, and they're not able to move it too well in this series.
The defense has some good series. This is one of them. Garrett Perry, Phillip Ferguson, Al Peterson. Al, I think, had one of his best games.
It's third down, and Peterson's going to sack Knicks again.
Another good sack, and we did a good job sacking the quarterback. Probably had 4 or 5 for a good many yards lost.
Brian Allison, number 71, was in there too, and they punted to you. You couldn't move it. You punted back, and Austin Hamilton had a couple of really good ones with good hang time.
Austin's done a good job for us. A good coverage there by Kevin Kendrick. And we have them inside the 20.
Again, Chattanooga can't do very much with it there. It looks like they slipped a little bit, but still a good pursuit. What about the shift here? It looks like the shift kind of fouled them up a little bit.
Well, we got a blitz, and we make a shift to keep them from picking up their blocking assignments and have another sack.
So Knicks goes down again. Looked like Al Peterson was in on that one more time. You get the football back, and again, John Bagwell.
Good block here by Alex Albert. And George Quarles. John gets another good run. John had his best day, I think, about 100 yards rushing.
Interception, though, spoiled that drive. So then UTC comes right back again. 3rd and 6. They get the 6, but good coverage.
Had good coverage, a good play. They made a good play and got the first down.
All right, so Knicks is going to be stopped this time, and he's going to roll to the left. Actually, he pitches the ball out, and Weber's going to make a nice play.
Sherrod played good. They had several throws on his side. He made good plays, a good tackle. Good defensive play.
Again, Knicks is going to try to throw, and again, number 75, Al Peterson, the senior out of Charleston's right there.
Al had a great game. He started off a little slow this year, but he's playing good. We've got to get everybody playing good as Al played yesterday.
Again, the ball came loose and went right to him, didn't it?
Seems that that's the way it happened. Good stop by Darryl Gardner.
All right, so now Chattanooga's going to try another field goal. Not as close as the first one, but not overly long, and they don't even come close. So again, another bullet dodged by Furman.
Yeah, I think we gave him too much practice on those field goals.
7-7 is the halftime score yesterday at Paladin Stadium, and you saw the Paladins running back up the hill, and they're going to try to get ready there for the second half. Were you going to make any changes coming up in the second 30 minutes?
Well, they did some things on defense we felt like we had to adjust to, made the adjustments. We felt good at half. We hadn't played that good offensively in particular. Felt like we could come back out, get some things going on offense, and we felt like we'd win the football game.
Well, you probably did do that. You did get some things going on offense in the second half.
Yeah, we got ahead and felt like we should have won the game at the end of the game, but made some mistakes that cost us the game.
We'll take a look at what happened in the second half yesterday at Paladin Stadium when we return with Coach Jimmy Satterfield here live on this Sunday morning.
In a recent survey of automobile quality, these two cars got the same excellent rating. The manufacturer of this car was rated number one in quality among Europeans. The manufacturer of this car was rated number one in quality among the Japanese. This car costs over $64,000. The Sentra costs about $6,400. Nissan puts quality in your price range. See your Upstate South Carolina Nissan dealer today.
Hi. I just moved in next door. Could I borrow a Diet Pepsi?
Sure.
To go out for is Diet Pepsi.
You okay in there?
Here's your Diet Pepsi.
Thanks. I hope it wasn't too much trouble.
No trouble at all.
Diet Pepsi, the choice of a new generation.
Welcome back. Taking a look at yesterday's ball game against UT Chattanooga. Furman against the Mocs. All tied up 7-7 at Paladin Stadium. And we're getting ready for the second half. John Bagwell limbering up and Coach Satterfield doing the same there at halftime. And again, you feel good going into the second 30 minutes.
Yeah, we felt like we could move the ball. We just execute. We'll make a good play here. And Chris Speaks gets hurt on this play and doesn't play anymore. But Keith Moore comes in and has a good game for him.
He got 13 yards. We're going to see it again from the bottom. And, of course, he gets hurt, but it didn't look like he got hit that hard.
I guess it's just the way he got hit. He sort of bruised some ribs, and he didn't play anymore after that play.
All right. So, yeah, you see him getting fitted with the flak jacket. It looks like from that picture, it looks like he may have thought about putting him back in, but Keith did well.
Keith did a good job. Came in and played good for us.
UTC's got the football. Pretty good coverage here by Wilson and Weber.
Rodman had good coverage, played good all day.
They complete this one, but Russell Rush with a nice tackle there.
Good individual tackle.
And again, they're just moving the ball down inside the 30, it appears, and good gang tackling. Again, number 46, Rush kind of forced it, and Dupree, and then Peterson again.
And Darrell Gardner forced the pitch, and we stopped that particular play.
Coach Nix probably wasn't too happy with his first kicker, tries a different one with not any better results. They miss another field goal. So it's all tied up still at 7 apiece. And we're going to take a look at Keith Moore coming up now here in the third quarter. He's going to go up on top to James Brown.
It's a good throw under pressure. Keith has a good pass to James and get a first down.
James made a couple of key catches.
Had some good catches. Here's Jeff Blankenship talking to Coach Wilson up top.
Chattanooga gets the football back again, and Nix is going to be hit this time. Well, actually threw it, and Rush was able to make a nice
hit. Good break on the ball there. Broke on the pass and made a good hit.
Watch number 71. He kind of forces Nix to throw it a little bit quicker, I think, than he wanted to.
Good effort there by Brian Allison and Al Peterson forcing the throw.
They had to punt the football back to you, and then you have it on offense again, and Keith Moore makes a nice play here.
It's a good option. This is a play we gained yards on several times. He makes a late pitch to John Bagwell, and another nice game.
Going to have the same combination coming up again, Keith Moore to John Bagwell.
This is an inside option, a good fake. Pitch is a little bit late. We'd rather have a little better execution there, but it gets results.
Well, I thought the object was to pitch it at the very last instant before you go down.
Well, if there's not too many people around there. See, this is Dwight Sterling, who probably hadn't got to run the ball quite enough because we haven't moved the ball enough on offense to keep enough people in the game.
The horse was in action yesterday as well. Almost a blocked punt there, but again, Alston gets it off. Good hang time.
Good coverage, good kick, and we have them in their territory again.
5 minutes to play in the third quarter, still all tied up 7-7, and they try to go right up the middle, and not very much there.
Pitts makes a good play. He's a sophomore from Clinton. He's played good.
Second down. This is going to be Paul Craven on the stop.
Paul was in there for giving Al Peterson a little rest and makes a good play.
First and 10 now at the Chattanooga 26. Moccasins with the football. And again, number 43, Darrell Gardner.
Good play by Darrell. A good hit. Russell Rush turns the play in. Good defense.
Tim Stepp is hurt. Kelly Smith is replacement number 47 there in on the stop.
Another fumble snap. Had 7 fumble snaps and didn't lose any of them. That's remarkable they can fumble that many times and not lose any of them.
It's great odds. Moccasins now at your 20-yard line, and Adrian with a pretty good play.
Super play by Adrian Dupree, the whole defense. It's a good effort.
7-7 now going into the fourth quarter. Still obviously anybody's ball game. Moccasins still have it in your territory. And number 50, watch Blankenship come out of nowhere there.
Jeff and Darrell had about 30 tackles between them and playing probably as good as they played together.
Third and 12 now for UTC, and again Weber on the coverage.
Good play by Sherrod, had him covered and forced him in another field goal.
This time though they make it, and as you said they had enough practice, and it's 10-7 now UTC. You get the football back. This series wasn't particularly good for Furman, although this was a pretty good run.
Good option run by Keith. And we still aren't consistent enough on offense to make enough first downs. They get the ball back.
You had to punt it back to him. Blankenship and gang tackling. Adrian's in there on another play for Furman. And now they're at your 14-yard line, though.
There's Dallas Forrest there in the stands. Golden Strip Nissan trying to encourage us on.
Very good. Chris Roper in on the stop for Paladins.
Chris made a good play. He hadn't played that much, but he was getting some playing time. That was a good play.
Again, they're going deep. Looks like they're trying to pick on Sherrod, but they didn't have very much success.
Not that time. They get another field goal, which really doesn't hurt us. We're going to have to score 7 points anyway, and we do.
Good catch. That ball almost came loose there, didn't it?
He held on. They have good gang tackling, but this is a good drive.
Third down and nine now. Excuse me, Coach. And Steve Gandy on the receiving end.
Steve Gandy's played good, filling in for Mark Rutter. Another good catch and another good first down.
So it's first down for the Paladins. Now it's going to be second down, 8 yards to go. And James Brown, the senior out of Columbia.
James makes a nice reception. We get another first down. We've got some momentum, and looks like we've got a chance to score.
Mixing the plays up pretty well. Keith Moore's going to keep it this time.
Keith makes a good run on an option, and we're inside their territory and have a good chance to score.
Now it's fourth down, 7 yards to go. You're going to go for it, just like you did last week against Western.
This is a good call by Bruce Fowler and Tim Sarles up top, decide on a rollout because they were doing a lot of blitzing, and Larry Grady, our clutch receiver, makes another good catch.
We're going to see this one from the bottom side. Again, you needed 7 yards. You got 24. You went for a lot more than seven.
Well, we had a play for 8 yards, and they had it covered. We said if he's covered, pump the ball, and he'll go deep. So we had him covered. We pumped the ball and went deep.
And again, Lamar Bell in with the score, so you're all tied up at 13-13 at this stage.
Mike Wood makes a great kick here to get us 14-13. Of course, Mike missed a field goal late in the game, but Mike Wood's been a super kicker for us. We won the several games. We tied Georgia Tech on his kick last year. We tied Appalachian on his kick last year. And he's still a good kicker for us and makes some good field goals for the season over.
All right, 14-13 now. The Paladins have the lead. Good defensive series. They can't do anything.
Well, we do what we've got to do right here to win the football game. We stop them on offense. We get the ball back, and this is a great play to get a first down. But I think the two key plays in the game coming up right here, we have a sweep where we get 2 yards, we have a base play where we get one, and the key for us to win is to rush the ball better offensively. We've got to rush the football in order to win, and we didn't do it right here at the end of the game, and consequently we get beat.
There was a fumble in there too, and Chattanooga got two big third down conversions. That was not one of them. But they do get in position for a field goal, and after missing a couple of rather easy ones, they kick a long one.
They make the field goal, but we really didn't rush the ball on offense, and that's the reason they had a chance to make that field goal.
16-14 now, Chattanooga, but the two-minute offense with a 45-second offense is going, and Gandy with a nice catch.
Nice catch. We did a great job on offense to get the ball back in position for a 48-yard field goal, but it really never should have come down to this.
All right, now Tim Fox is going to be on the receiving end. He just gets out of bounds, and there's 2 seconds left on the clock.
We did a good job, did everything we had to do right there to get in position. Mike hit a good field goal, just wasn't quite long enough. And like I say, he's made some great kicks for us. He's one of the best kickers we've ever had, and he'll make some more good ones.
Well, as a coach, you'd like to see 48-yard field goals made, but you want more consistency on the makeable ones, and these are just kind of gravy, aren't they?
Well, you know, you have a chance to win it, and he's a competitor and did a good job to go in there and hit it as well as he did. We just didn't quite come up with enough.
Came awfully, awfully close, though. First downs, Chattanooga had a slight advantage. You had the advantage on the rushing side, very key stat there. So the total offense was very close. Turnovers, though, that may have hurt a little bit, huh?
Well, they have 7 fumbles and don't lose any. We have 4 fumbles and lose 2, and 2 of them are real key fumbles.
On the individual side, John Bagwell had a pretty good game, rushing the ball almost 100 yards on the ground. We'll take a break, and then when we come back, we'll tour the Furman campus live on this Sunday morning right after this.
If you're looking for quality in a new car, take a look at these. They're why Nissan is rated number one. A recent independent survey named Nissan number one in quality and reliability among all Japanese and domestic manufacturers. And now your Nissan dealer has special factory incentives that could save you hundreds. So if you want a car that's truly reliable, if you want a car with real quality priced right, see your upstate South Carolina Nissan dealer today.
I'll have a burger with everything and a large fry.
You need a drink?
Yeah, of course. I meant a Pepsi.
Ooh.
If you want great refreshment, just say what you mean.
I'll make that two Pepsis.
Pepsi, the choice of a new generation.
Looking for a great deal on the hottest sports car around? Your Nissan dealer's got it. With big year-end savings on the sensational Pulsar NX with a powerful 16-valve engine. And right now, we've got the biggest Pulsar selection ever. So we've got to make you a great deal. Come in now and we'll sweeten the deal with factory incentives that could save you up to $500 more. Big selection, year-end savings, and factory incentives. This could be your last chance to get a great deal on the hot new Pulsar. Get big year-end savings at your upstate South Carolina Nissan dealer.
Well, if you watch this on Sunday mornings, you see the beauty of the Furman surroundings, the surroundings around Paladin Stadium, Paris Mountain there, and how really nice it is, especially this kind of time of year. And the beautiful campus at Furman has to create a pretty good working environment too, doesn't it, Coach?
It's a great place. We have a great campus. This is an excellent place to watch a football game. Had a good crowd out there yesterday. And it's just, we have some recruits over yesterday. It's a good place to bring them into.
I don't know if you can really tour Furman University in 2.5 minutes. We're going to try to do that in just a second. Tell us a little bit about our tour guide this morning.
Well, we have Lee Satterfield here on the tour guide, and hopefully she can tell us a little bit about the campus.
Well, I'm sure she will. Let's go ahead and take a quick look at Furman University.
Founded in 1826, Furman University, a private co-educational college with 2,500 students, has established a reputation as one of the finest liberal arts colleges in the nation. Academic excellence is a tradition here at Furman University. Here on campus at the library, students come to enjoy each other's company, study, and research. University might be one of the greatest places in the world for jogging and biking. You can find them out here all hours during the day, early in the morning, late at night, even in the heat of the day. Another popular spot on Furman's campus is the 30-acre lake. Overlooking this lake is the bell tower. The lake's a popular spot on campus for boating, fishing, feeding the ducks, swimming also. Speaking of fishing, we ran across a couple of players over here. Patrick Bain and Keith Swilling. Hey guys, how y'all doing?
Not too well.
Not too well?
Not going too well.
How about you, Patrick? You catching anything?
I had a bite all day.
You're kidding!
No bites.
Tell the truth, Patrick. Is this the real reason you came to Furman University?
The only reason. It's a nice lake out here.
One of the many recreations at Furman is swimming in the Pack Building. Racquetball. Tennis. Golf. And intramural softball. A proud heritage, strong academics, excellent facilities, and excellence in athletics are all part of one of the nation's top liberal arts colleges, Furman University.
All right, Coach, how'd you like that tour?
Lee did a good job. Someone said that Furman would be a great place to go to school if you didn't have to go to class.
All right. How about that lake? Are there fish in there?
I think there are a few fish in there. Patrick's caught a few. They caught a nice one that day. They didn't show it. It came up with a big tin can, I think.
About an 18-pounder, huh?
That's right.
All right. Well, of course, the Paladins play football. They're not professional fishermen. And we'll come back and take a look at next Saturday's ball game against the Marshall Thundering Herd right after you take a look at this.
Thank you. Looking for a great deal on the economy car ranked number one in quality? Your Nissan dealer's got it. With big year-end savings on all Nissan Sentras, we've got the best selection ever of quality-built Sentras with prices starting at $66.39. And right now, we'll sweeten the deal with factory incentives that could save you up to $500 more. Big selection, year-end savings, and factory incentives. This could be your best chance ever to get a great deal on a great car. Get big year-end savings at your upstate South Carolina Nissan dealer.
All right, Furman Paladins off two successive losses now, unfortunately. Western Carolina last week, UT Chattanooga yesterday. Marshall's coming in. I think some people say, well, at least you got a breather now. That's not exactly true, is it?
Marshall's got one of the best teams in the league. They were last year one of the best teams offensively. They're better on offense probably than Western and Chattanooga. They throw the ball a lot. They just got off of a win yesterday, and they'll be a real tough opponent for us.
Do they throw it as much as they used to when Fodor was the quarterback?
Probably not quite that much, but they got a junior college quarterback who's been real successful throwing the football. And Marshall was one of the best teams we played last year. We had one of our best games against them, and they'll be a tough opponent.
So this will probably be a high-scoring affair coming up next Saturday at Paladin.
Probably will be. Hopefully it wouldn't, but it probably will be.
We'll keep our fingers crossed on that. What's going to be the key to getting back on the winning ways for you?
Well, I think the basic key is for us to rush the football better. We've rushed the ball some, but over the years we've led the conference in rushing the football. We've led the nation in rushing the football. And right at the end of the game yesterday, we had two plays were keys. We had a sweep where we just gained 2 yards, had a base play where we didn't gain any yards. To me, I think we've got to rush the football better where the
children and with a few simple precautions.